Welcome back to the tutorial. Welcome back to our channel once again. In this video, you want to see how we can convert the APK file into .sw file so you can upload it into your Sketchware app and edit it as full Sketchware projects. If you have ever seen a nice app application and wonder how you can own such application or turn such application to be your own by editing the functionalities, modify those interface and so on, this tutorial is for you. So before we begin, make sure you click the subscribe button below, turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our future updates. Technical aspect of this video, let's understand these two files known as APK file and SW file. An APK file is simply the compiled version of an Android application, while the SW file is the backup file format used by Sketchware to store app projects. So what are we going to do in this tutorial is to take an APK file, reference, convert it into a Sketchware project format so it can be edited and same way as if you originally created it in Sketchware application. Before we reach the end of this practical tutorial, yeah, the first step is to extract the APK contents. The next step is to decode the file to readable format, and the third one is to convert the directory structure to Sketchware project format, and the last one is for us to compress it back into the .sw file ready for import. Don't worry, everything that you hear, that you have seen it in this video, I will walk you through each step clearly. By the end of this process, your APK will open just like any other project to you built in Sketchware: editable block, UI layout, and all resources accessible. So before we continue our tutorial, we need three applications. We need these two strong applications before we can continue. What application? The first one, we need this anti-split G2 application, and we have the second one here known as empty manager. Most important, we need this empty manager first before we can start. So if you don't have any of it, you'll find a way to download it from maybe APK app stores, or you can see the comments, the link in the comment section of this video. And then last thing is we need our Sketchware application to work on the exported file. That is what we need for now. If any other additional application that will be needed in this tutorial, you also find it on the screen. Let's begin right now. Let's look for any APK app to make use of. If we should use this one, okay, let's use the one that is from Google Play Store so that you believe that this tutorial works well. This one, first of all, I use this one. Let's take this one to this place. You can see this application ready. This is the UI designer for any maybe button or whatever. So this application is in Google Play Store. You can see the application fashion here. So this application is Google Play Store. You can download it as an example of this video. I want to make use of this app. So note that not all the application works from this format, and also don't misuse this application or this tutorial in a wrong way. Don't clone anybody's working app. This tutorial is for educational purpose, it's not for misleading or whatever. Now let's dive into it. You can see that the app is 7.7. I see the application details on Google Play Store here. You'll find it that see the app was installed through Google Play Store. I can uninstall it and install it back. So you believe that this tutorial is not just copy and paste tutorial, is tutorial from scratch. I'm installing it again so that you get it as well. If you have ever experienced such tutorials, don't forget to share it with friends and click the notification bell, turn it on for more tutorial like this. Application is installing right now, so it's ready to open. We open it from here. you can still open it from there. Let's just open it from there and observe the application. You see the function, the interface of it as well. We may make use of some few features in this application. Look at the splash screen of the application, so you understand when we clone the, when we finish our tutorial, you can see the function, exactly function. You can see any other thing like this, you can see it like this. So then let's begin again. Now after that, we have forgotten the application that we want to use, so we want to use this application right here. Before that, how can we make it? Remember, the application name is Ready. So we open the our empty manager like I showed you earlier. We need this application empty manager here. So you open your empty manager application. After that, you click on this side menu, slide up menu here, this menu button here, side menu. Once you click on it, you come down to this place known as APK, extract APK here. So as you click on the extract APK, fortunately we have the app at top. This is the app that you want to export and make use of it. So you click on it. Once you click on it, you click on this particular button here, this area, extract APK. So you click on it there, you wait for it. After that, you can, you see that the where the folder of this file is empty to is the there. So you can click here to locate the folder directly, or you can just close and go back to the folder area. So you open it to understand exactly where the folder or where the file is locating. So you scroll down, you see empty to, just like how you see it here in my own screen. This is what we mean, MT2 here. So MT2. So you open it. Once you open it, you open the APK face folder known as APKs, the APKs folder. So once you open it, we have it here. This is the file here. So note that this file cannot be changed, because this file, now this file contains split application and the application, the APK file and the split APK. Let's just open the app and we see view. So you see that this app now, it's having face APK and the split APK, which is not possible to compile it, to change it. So what we have to do is to merge it. We have to merge this APK file. How can we merge it? We minimize back to our home screen here. That's when we need this part application known as anti-splits G2, because we have split file there. So we need to make this anti-split. You open the anti-split. As you open the anti-split, it will look like this. After that, you have to do click on the this icon here, this folder icon here. You click on it. Once you click on it, you go to that same file folder that we open, MT2. So once you open it, open the APKs as well. Fortunately, we have it here. See, the last file here is the ready that we just extracted, and we want to merge them. So you click on it to merge. It will come down to here. Once it come down to here, don't do anything than to click on this merge button here. So you click on the merge button and wait for it to finish merging. After the merging of it, you see everything will be successfully merged. So it's working successfully. You see the message below here that everything is completed successfully in this place. So you see it is in the same folder that you want, you will see it there. So open, minimize your screen again. So you come back to your empty manager, that same folder, you can see it here. After the merge, this is the one that we didn't merge, this is the one that we just merged. It has turned to normal APK right now. So we want to make use of this normal APK right now. We want to make use of this signed one. So what you have to do is to click and hold on it. Once you click and hold on it, you compress it. You want to compress it to another file. So you click on the compress in that place, zip like this. So you click on this place to change the format to TAR, that's TAR. You click on it and change it to TAR here. So once it's in TAR, you click on the OK button here, you compress it. So you wait for it to finish the compress. After that, it finished compressing it. So the compressing of the application of the file is done. So look at the compressed file here. So you have to click and edit it. You rename, open the rename button here. This rename, as if you want to rename the file. So you click and delete it, rename it. So once you rename, you can just delete some things like this. You click this one, you now you change, remove the TAR and put SWB. So that's the file, SWB. And then you click on the OK button. You click on the OK button and save the file. We have our file ready. That's the file that we just have. So what we have to do is to can pick this file into the backup file in our Sketchware. So you come to this site. At the area of this site like this, you look for Sketchware. you see the file on the screen there, so you click on it. Once you click on it, come to this backup area, backups. So you click on the backups. So you have to create a folder in this place. Yes, you create a folder. Let's say we want to create a folder here. Create a folder that you put this file into it. You create a folder. Let's say ready. My own folder is this is the name that I give to my folder. I give this name ready Sketchware UI. So I click on the OK button. I create the folder. So after that, that's the folder here. You can see the folder here. So you open the folder. What you have to do is to move this file into this particular folder. So you move this file into the particular folder. What is there is to click and hold. You click on move. You click on the move. Then you click on OK. It will move. So we have our folder in our Sketchware here. So look at it here. This is the folder, and this is it. So we have to go to our let's go to our Sketchware app, and you want to go to our Sketchware app right here. Open our Sketchware app so we install or restore it into our Sketchware app. So this is our Sketchware app. Close it. You can see that I don't have any other project. This is just a tutorial project, simple project. So everywhere here is empty. Click on this restore. You click on the restore. Fortunately, you can see luckily this is our folder we just created. So it's open at, to the place automatically because we move everything into the Sketchware folder. So first Sketchware recognize its backup folder before any other files or folders. So as we open it, this is open on it, and you click on the open the folder. You see the app there. This is the file, the project file that we just move it into. You can see it look like it will something that will work. So you click on the check button, check it, and you click on this. As you used to restore folder this in file, click on the select. You select it, you wait for it to finish restore. After that, look at it here. You can see the icon, everything. You see the running, you can see the let's say you observe some things here that we have exactly. We have the package name. If you can want to observe the package name of the other one, they are the same thing. Either the thing is added a random package name because of cloning, it add another S. If you want to use the other one, let's go back to see it has 7.7 like convert it. Okay, let's see. Say you want to make a try to open it, see if it will open already. Since you are able to move it, it will be also able to dive it into it. Now this is the interface, everything is working the same. Yeah, this is the interface. You can see it's everything here. So you click on run to run the application and see if it will normally work like other. So our APK file is almost ready. We want to check on it and see if it will work like the other original application. Okay, the APK file is ready to install, so we need to install it right here. It's installing. Let's open it. You want to open it and see if it will looks like the original one. You can see it's almost, it's everything working like the original one. You can see it. Let's see the same thing that's happened to, you can see it here, everything, the same thing that happened to the other one, it's happened. That means you can own application from APK file. You can see it, everything is working the same thing. Let's scroll down and see all the functionalities here. Let's navigate to the original application right here. Look at the original application right here. Look at it here. Everything. Yeah, look at the functionality also. So that is how to convert an APK into a .swb Sketchware project file. If this video tutorial you see everything is in your hand, you work with us as well. So if this tutorial helped you, please like this video, drop a comment below, and share it with other Sketchware developers. And if you are new to our channel, like I said earlier, if you are new to our video tutorial, don't forget to subscribe for more Sketchware programming tips and app development guides are coming here every moment. So thank you for watching this video. See you again in our next tutorial.